This scene will describe the structure of the insect midgut. In some predaceous insects with piercing sucking mouthparts, extraoral digestion occurs by injecting digestive enzymes into the prey and then drawing back the liquefied tissue along with the enzymes. But in most insect species, the midgut is the primary region for food digestion and nutrient absorption. Let us look at the organization of the midgut. Gastric ceca are diverticula located at the entry to the midgut, followed by the ventriculus. Gastric ceca expand the surface area of the midgut exposed to hemolymph for absorption of digested nutrients and are shown to absorb monosaccharides such as glucose, fructose, and mannose, free amino acids, and lipid derivatives such as acylglycerides. Although gastric ceca are located at the anterior of the ventriculus, the ceca absorb nutrients both as they enter from salivary digestion in the crop and by countercurrent flows of digested nutrients within the ventriculus. Here is a magnification of the ventriculus wall to show its cellular organization. Midgut muscle layers are reversed from those of the foregut, with circular muscles innermost and longitudinal muscles outermost. The muscles do not uniformly cover the entire midgut surface, and many of the midgut cells are covered on the hemolymph side by only the basal lamina. The midgut consists of four cell types: columnar cells, regenerative cells, goblet cells, and endocrine cells. Let us look at the features and functions of each cell type. Columnar cells are the most abundant cell type and form a microvillar brush border on the apical side of the cell, facing into the lumen of the midgut. The microvilli greatly increase the surface area of the columnar cells for digestive enzyme secretion and absorption of the resulting digested nutrients. The surface of microvilli are coated with a viscous secretion of glycoproteins and lipids called the glycocalyx, that can entrap and concentrate secreted enzymes in digestive products. Columnar cells have mitochondria and endoplasmic reticulum on the apical side for the synthesis and secretion of digestive enzymes. On the basal side, there are extensive infoldings of the basal plasma membrane to increase the surface area for release of absorbed nutrients to the hemolymph. Columnar cells are short-lived and are replaced every 2 to 5 days by regenerative cells located at the base of the columnar cells, sometimes found in clumps called nidi. Goblet cells have a large central cavity lined with microvilli containing mitochondria and facing the gut lumen. Goblet cells are interdispersed among the columnar cells, and they transport potassium ions into the midgut lumen by energy-dependent hydrogen-potassium ion pumps located in their apical membrane. Goblet cells likely play a role in forming the alkaline pH characteristic of the midgut in many plant-feeding insects such as Lepidoptera larvae. Unlike vertebrate digestive systems, which are strongly acidic, the pH of insect digestive systems are highly variable and adapted to the nature of the food. The midgut pH of Lepidoptera larvae range from a slightly alkaline to highly alkaline depending on the nature of the plants and their chemical content. Endocrine cells are few and scattered and are elongate with dark secretory granules along their basal membranes where the hormones are released into the hemolymph by exocytosis. Gastric endocrine cells typically secrete peptide hormones and monoamines. Midgut hormones may affect physiological processes related to nutrient intake and the nutritional state of the insect, such as feeding activity, gut motility, water balance, metamorphosis, and likely reproduction. During insect embryogenesis, the ectoderm layer gives rise to the epidermal cells of the outer body wall and the foregut and hindgut, all of which secrete a protective chitin-containing layer of cuticle on their outer surface. However, Midgut epidermal cells are derived from the embryonic endoderm layer and do not secrete a layer of surface cuticle. Instead, midgut cells secrete a loose, membrane-like peritrophic matrix that lines the midgut lumen and encloses the food. The peritrophic matrix consists of an organized lattice of chitin microfibers embedded in a glycoprotein matrix that creates a molecular sieve. The peritrophic matrix acts as an ultrafilter that protects midgut cells from mechanical and chemical damage and from infection by microorganisms. Yet, the matrix is porous and allows enzymes to diffuse into the midgut lumen and digested nutrients to diffuse out. There are two types of peritrophic matrix. Type 1 matrix are found in the majority of insect species and consist of a series of sheets secreted along the entire midgut surface such that the inner sheet surrounds the food and moves along with the food bolus as it progresses through the midgut. Type 2 matrix are found in Diptera and Dermaptera. Type 2 matrix are secreted by specialized cells located in the anterior midgut behind the stomatal valve and form a single continuous sleeve lining the entire lumen of the midgut. The next scene will describe the processes of digestion and absorption of nutrients.